So this is our first day on this expedition. We started here in the middle of Gatun Lake, which is the man-made lake, the freshwater lake that connects both the Atlantic and the Pacific Ocean here in the canal. So pretty much this morning, we're gonna explore this lake and all the wildlife that is within the Panama Canal watershed, which is a network of national parks that protects, you know, the water that feeds the canal. This morning we're exploring the islands that are the man-made islands that were made when this entire valley was flooded, and it's a great place to see some wildlife. We had an opportunity of seeing black mantle holler monkeys, white-faced capuchin monkeys, even the small little red-naped tamarin, which is small little marmosets that are almost endemic to this part of the world, just found between central Panama and just a little tip there of Colombia. So it's a great way to start our morning by seeing all these primates around these islands. We saw some great birds as well, like the snail kite, the limpkin, you know, and some other smaller shore birds like the jacana. So it was a great morning, a great way to start our morning. The red-naped tamarin is our most primitive monkey. It's more close related to monkeys in the old world, lemurs. Has interesting characteristics on his bodies. Instead of nails, claws, a long, non-prehensive tail that helps the monkey with its balance, but not with its grasp, because it has no control over it. So it differs a little bit from the more evolved monkeys, like the black holler monkey or the capuchin monkey that we get around here. White-faced capuchin monkeys, they're very iconic. They're one of those monkeys that you get to see in movies, that you get to see in stories all the time, and it's because it's a highly adaptive monkey, very good when it comes to using tools to get its food. Its feeding habits are quite broad. You know, they go anything from insects, mosquitoes, fruit, leaves, even small mammals like squirrels or eggs or birds. So it's a very, very active, you know, wild monkey with a very fast metabolism. So it's very distinctive and definitely, you know, a centerfold of the tropics. We've had a couple great views of sloths this morning. Specifically the tree-toed sloth, which is the most active one during the daytime. So we saw one just climbing a vine as we were entering the National Park Soberanía. Great view of the tree-toed sloth. You know, they also have a very slow metabolism. They move quite slow, but as we saw, whenever they really want to go fast, they press that pedal and they go. You know, but overall, you know, they spend most of their time up in the trees, sunbathing, relaxing, eating their leaves. That's just the average daytime of a tree-toed sloth.